Hi, Dr. Olushola Ajide here. In this video, I'll be addressing the issue of cultural shock during the PhD program. Now, quite a lot of persons, when they are transitioning from developing nations to come to developed world to do a PhD program or to do a master's program, they are not actually prepared for changes. And these changes, I call them cultural shocks. Now, part of the things is the fact that there's a different culture from where we, whoever is coming from and coming to the West for a program. And it's the lack of preparedness for this shock oftentimes affect even the mental state of the student in actually focusing and delivering on the academic pursuit that they've come for. And I think it's extremely important for students who are coming from developing world moving to the West for either a master's program or a PhD program should understand and be prepared for the transition, the change from the environment where they find themselves and into the environment in which they will be studying for maybe 1 year, 2 years, 3 or 4 years, as the case might be. It's important to have this preparedness. Now, how do you undo these shocks? Number one, it's important to know that there's a change in culture where you're coming from and try to take some practical steps to get acculturized, practical steps to get to understand the way of life in the environment where you have moved to, within the environment, within the university, the culture within the university, the culture within the city where you are stated, and the culture within the country where you are actually domiciled for your PhD or your master's program. It's extremely important to know how to get used to it. One of those cultural things is the issue of the weather, for example. Here in Aberdeen is a very, often very cold environment, as opposed to somebody coming from the tropics coming to Aberdeen to have a to do a program. The first harsh reality will be the fact that the weather is cold, and it's important that the students have a mental change in the mind of how to change being aware or used to a tropical environment and moving to a very temperate weather. So it's important that you be able to do this shift. Now, I've only mentioned the issue of weather, tackling the issue of weather. Another cultural shift is the fact that the type of people you meet as you move around. If you're going to be in a diverse, in a diverse class in which if you have lectures, if you don't have lectures, you're just PhD, quite a lot of persons you're going to be meeting, and there's a need to be able to understand how the perspective and the cultures of other people you're going to be meeting with or studying with or relating with or sharing the same office with. This is extremely important because it will go a long way to determine the success of your academic journey, the success of your PhD program. You might actually find it that sometimes this could be very unsettling, that it affects your mental process of delivering in your academic PhD journey. So it's important that you get prepared for the changes that will happen within the PhD program because you are moving from your country into another country. Now, another key thing which I would put as part of culture is the change in which people learn in the West as opposed to the developing nations. Now, here in the West, the style and the, of teaching, the style of learning, either in a PhD or a master's program, is totally different from how it is in the developing world. And one of it is that one of the first shock that most students, when they move to this way, is the fact that they might expect to be spoon-fed, which is not same here in the West, in which you are supposed to be a self-learner. You are supposed to be a self-motivated learner, in which you are supposed to go and find out all the information by yourself. So, you know, you are supposed to be able to sit down and be able to research this information and find them out. Nobody actually will be spoon-feeding you when you come to study in the West. And it's one of the key shocks in which students that come from the developing world often they'll be asking, oh, it wasn't like that when I did my undergraduate program in my country. Well, surprise, surprise. Is a different environment where you have your undergraduate program, and it's a different environment now in the West. So you need to be able to find a way of coping strategies to be able to overcome, to be able to be prepared, to be able to succeed in your academic journey. Now that you have moved, transitioned from a developing world to the West, you need to know that the style of learning, you need to know that the way things work academically is different. So please get this understanding, and I believe strongly if you do this, it will help you significantly in moving towards the road of success in your PhD journey, in your PhD program, and it will help you get unstuck, because sometimes it takes months for students to be able to get used to this change, and it cripples you. You're not able to progress in your academic journey, you're not able to progress in your writing, and before you know it, time is going. I believe and I hope these tips today have helped you, and I ask that you should please subscribe to this channel. If you want any topic in which you want me to address, just leave your comment below and we'll find time and, you know, do the recording and see how to help. Don't forget, these tips and recordings are to help you move towards completion in your PhD program, to get unstuck and to be able to help you to graduation. Interestingly, tomorrow is my own graduation, and I'm looking forward to it. So I'll see you again in the next video. Bye.